Health systems all over the world are under crisis. The inefficient rollout of scientific information and the prevalence of fake news exacerbates an infodemic that is happening right on our screens. But what makes the Philippines the social media capital of the world, especially prone to infodemics? With over 89 million active social media users, mostly on YouTube, Facebook, and Instagram, combined with a lack of a dedicated infodemic crisis response team, the Philippines is facing the perfect storm. A COVID-19 response of vaccination fiascos, prolonged lockdowns, subsequent job losses, and staggering casualties have led to decreased social cohesion on the ground. Amid efforts of the Philippine Department of Health and other stakeholders, the infodemic still rages on. We in Mediasina say it's time for a different approach. One that replaces the notion of people not knowing better and that replaces the notion of systems simply being reactive. Instead, we want to be more proactive by understanding sentiments, increasing foresight, and responding to oncoming crises before they even become infodemics. With this in mind, we present Project Dinig, a tech-driven solution with the Filipino people at its core. Inspired by the misinformation and vaccine hesitancy field guide of the WHO, we want to create a task force within the Health Promotion Bureau of the Department of Health, or the DOH, in coordination with the disaster risk reduction management arms of local governments. This task force aims to address the four levels of infodemic management. For our short-term objectives, we want to monitor and collect data through digital and community-based means, to analyze and stratify misinformation according to level of risk, and to direct the creation of credible and timely health information materials on a rolling basis. For our long-term objectives, we want to systematize the creation of health communication strategies in response to rising misinformation, to reinforce the position of the DOH as a source of credible and reliable information, and to document misinformation and their corresponding public health interventions through a technical report and an algorithm.
Guided by the four steps of infodemic management, we plan to combat misinformation in the Philippines as our project unfolds. First is the prepare phase, where we train a dedicated corps of individuals tasked with describing information ecosystems in urban, rural, and digital settings. This aims to clarify nationalized data and to fit it into the proper local contexts, opening the possibility of regional health information campaigns for a more specific audience. Building infrastructure for digital and community monitoring addresses the limitation of not being able to localize misinformation via digital monitoring alone, which was deemed as a major problem by the DOH in managing the infodemic. Digital monitoring involves full-time social media trackers and data analysts trained in the use of various online tracking tools and armed with skills in data triangulation and analysis. For this step, capacity building is key. Complementing digital monitoring, partnerships will be made with local communities and their designated health workers. Three pilot communities will have their information ecosystems mapped using SMS-based questionnaires and focus group discussions, gauging their vaccine hesitancy, barriers to vaccination, and sources of information. We now proceed to step two, the listen phase. For digital monitoring, the task force will employ both active listening, which targets non-engaging individuals by monitoring RSS feeds, and passive listening, which caters to seekers of information via Facebook Messenger and SMS chatbots. Current data collection methods, such as DOH's Facebook chatbot and hotlines, will be linked with rapid pro-based applications in effective live community settings. Insights from local experts and community-based surveys will help provide regional balance to our data to map out the geographical origins of the misinformation, better capturing people's thoughts. From these efforts, a proper rumor log will be made, a memory of your infodemic response, much like how vaccination gives your immunity a basis and how to act if another threat comes along.
We now proceed to the understand phase, which focuses on making sense of all of the data we've collected so far. We first have to stratify the data on a rolling basis according to velocity and source of spread, potential risk, and real-world consequences. Our inspiration for stratifying COVID-19 issues is the priority matrix. The simplified approach makes it easier for decision makers to respond on time. Community monitoring, as described in the previous phases, comes in to help the task force determine the real scope of viral issues. Misinformation that is of high risk and of wide scope will necessitate debunking measures of similar scale, while misinformation that is of low risk and limited scope may just necessitate pre-booking. The task force will also be linked to a network of experts across multiple disciplines such as public health, mass communication, economics, and the social sciences to formulate action points apt for the sentimental context gathered from the data. The final step, engage, comes in when we translate our more efficient decision-making strategy into action. These will be carried out by the Health Communication and External Relations Divisions of the Health Promotion Bureau. When emergency notifications that provide up-to-date and actionable information on breaking topics is disseminated to citizens by the NDRRMC system, and when information and educational campaign materials are made to engage people both mentally and emotionally, Filipinos can rest easy knowing that Dinig covers them. In the long term, learnings from our experiences can serve as the basis for future health promotion and educational material. An annual report based on the same data will serve as our system of continuous documentation, monitoring, and evaluation.
This is our proposed timeline of activities. The prepare phase will occur from July to August of 2021. Here, we will build our human resource arm, set up our tech infrastructure, and affirm partnerships with pilot communities.
The latter two phases, listen, understand, and engage, will then be initiated in September. These steps will be done simultaneously and continuously to ensure proactiveness. There will be monthly and emergency meetings with on-call experts, depending on the data stratification results. Multiple outcomes will be used to track our impact in these months. Health materials published and corresponding online engagement will be monitored. Chatbot users and their inquiries will also be collected. Baseline metrics will be used to compare the public's feedback prior to and after the generation of publicity materials. These will be complemented by qualitative data gathered from regular focus group discussions among community health workers and members. By December 2021, we plan to materialize preliminary statistics through our proof of concept that involves our three pilot communities, paving the way for greater legislative and executive action. By 2022, an infodemic management report and health information handling algorithm will be released. Concurrent to this will be the expansion of the scope of the task force, such that they will be able to monitor more communities in the country. Here is our proposed budget. We plan to hire health workers who are existing social listeners in their communities, while data analysts already working for the DOH will be carried over into this task force. $21,100 will be allotted for building tech infrastructure through partnerships with SMS companies and through Rapid Pro program development. $8,400 will be used for marketing of the chatbot to encourage feedback from Filipinos and to augment digital monitoring. These will be done by community caravans, face-to-face announcements, and printed information paraphernalia. Each of the on-call experts will be given a small honorarium.
Gathering stakeholders may prove difficult due to the lockdown and other equally pressing COVID-19 projects. Thus, we will collaborate with targeted stakeholders and agree on attainable goals for their contribution to this project. Optimizing the number of stakeholders will expedite decision-making, allowing for a more prompt response to topics that gain traction online. Motivating citizens to answer SMS surveys may also be a challenge. We will work closely with affluent members of their communities to better relay our purpose for change. To ensure sustainability, community monitoring will serve as the core of our multi-pronged solution. The three pilot communities we have selected are based in Cavite and are already in partnership with the University of the Philippines Department of Community Medicine. Disaster risk response teams will be leveraged as watchdogs against oncoming infodemics. Since they are trusted figures and are stakeholders in this information system, they will serve as primary social barometers in their respective communities. Physician Society representatives from various fields and communities will be invited to collaborate for consensus building on rising health topics. This culminates in an integrative session that aims to build consensus among constituents for future use of the DOH. This will result in a technical report and an algorithm that details the division steps in releasing health information. Both will serve as a robust addition to disaster preparedness that can protect the future generations against potential health information crises.
Our health system is under crisis, but it need not be for long. We at Mediasina believe that public health in the Philippines extends beyond the screen. Our community approach will ensure that Filipinos will benefit from our task force. With social listening and understanding through online and on-ground means, Project Dinig affirms that the answer is amongst the people. We're here to find a way to listen.